morning, everyone! Bago natin mapanood ang aming video reaction, meron muna akong 5 questions para dun sa mapapanood nating video ngayon. So, the first question is, how did nursing start or when did nursing start? Second question is, life of Florence Nightingale. The third question is, formal education or training in nursing old and now? The fourth question is modern practice of nursing. And the last but not the least, modern tool or technology in nursing old and now? Introduction. The evolution of nursing. Nursing or taking care of others was untaught during primitive times. Nursing before 80s was not valued in society. Nursing started at home because their traditional way of taking care of sick people only at their home. Wayward women that they called, instead of going to jail as their punishment, they do nursing stuff. So that women are just like slaves before because they are just following orders from religious community. In the Christian era, Christianity had a large influence on women to becoming nursing because of the experience that they have on the Christian era, they form an organized group. Women dedicated themselves on taking care of others. At the year 1854, Mary Grant C. Cole worked together with Florence Nightingale during the Crimean War to give help aid for the wounded Russian soldiers. So, magtungo po tayo ngayon sa pangalawang question, life background of Florence Nightingale. So, Florence Nightingale was named after the city Florence, Italy, where she was born on May 12, 1821, an upper-class British family. So, tinawag po siyang the Lady with Lamb. Then, she was died on August 13, 1910 at her home in London. Her parents are Frances Nightingale, mother, ina po niya, and ang pangalan po ng tatay niya is William Shore Nightingale. At the age of 24 daw po, si Nightingale defied her parents to marry a suitable man and left England to study nursing, where she took a nursing job in the Middlesex. Nightingale was promoted a superintendent within just a year being hired. On October 1853, the Crimean War broke out. British Empire against Russian Empire. During late 1854, Nightingale received a letter asking her to organize a corps of nurses, tend to the sick and fallen soldiers in Crimea. So, kaya po siya tinawag na Lady with the Lamb. Then, Nightingale made a mission to improve hygiene practices, significantly lowering the death rate at the hospital. The hard work took a toll on her health. She had just barely recovered when the biggest challenge of her career is to present itself. And then next, Queen Victoria helped Nightingale to create a royal commission into the health of the army. Her polar diagram was known as Nightingale Rose Diagram, which decreases the death rate and made new accessible to all inspiring new standards for sanitation in the army and beyond. She became the first female member of the Royal Statistical Society and was named honorary member of American Statistical Association. On August 1910, Nightingale suffered from unknown illness but seemed recovered and reportedly in good spirit. On Friday of August 12, 1910, she was died unexpectedly at her home in London. Nagtapos na po yung kanyang karir, pero naging inspirasyon po siya sa lahat ng mga tao noon during their time na naging isang mabuti po siyang nurse. Florence Nightingale Museum sits at the site of the original Nightingale Training School for Nurses, which houses more than 2,000 artifacts commemorating the life and career of the Angel of Crimea. Florence Nightingale is broadly acknowledging and revealed as the pioneer of modern nursing.
So, pupunta naman tayo sa number 3 question. Formal education or training in nursing, old and now. Dito, malalaman lang natin kung paano yung pag-aaral ng nursing tsaka pag-training, kung ano yung pinagkaiba nila dati tsaka ngayon. So, nursing education is theoretical and practical training provided to nurses with the purpose to prepare them for their duties as nursing care professional. Siguro alam naman natin pag sa nursing ka, parang prepare ka na agad sa work ganun sa medical field. So, ang susunod ay tungkol kay James Durham's. James Durham's name stand out in the history of nursing as the first African-American who practiced medicine in the United States. So, si James Durham's pala ay isang African-American. Siya ang pinakaunang naging MD na African-American. Then, this was in 18th century. Durham did not possess a formal degree and he was born into slavery. So, wala MD siya pero wala siyang nahawakan na degree. Siguro dahil na rin sa slavery, sa pagpapahirap sa kanila ganun. But the training he received from his owner, who were doctors, helped him become a freeman. Ah, yun, tinulungan naman pala siya ng mga parang boss nila ganun ng mga doktor para makalaya siya. Thus, nursing education attained a formal status in 1860s. And this were Florence Nightingale comes in. Kilala niyo naman siguro si Florence Nightingale, yung binanggit kanina ni Aubrey. She became a worldwide symbol for her service in nursing. Ah, dito na siya nakikilala, dito na namamayagpag yung pangalan niya. And she was the one responsible for setting up the first nursing training school at St. Thomas Hospital, London in 1860. Yun, sumisikat na nga siya, kaya siya na rin yung pinamamahala dito sa first nurse training school sa London. And Florence Nightingale devised a complete curriculum of nursing practices for the first time nursing education was defined. So siya na rin parang yung nag-introduce, tapos siya na rin gumawa ng parang mga ituturo sa mga nurse. So, dito naman tayo sa 1885. In 1885, Japan came with the first nursing institute and the next year, United States followed. So, Japan ang merong pinakaunang nursing institute. Lillian Wald initiated the idea of visiting nursing when she began teaching a home nursing class in the late 1800s. So, si Lillian Wald pala, nagtuturo siya ng mga nurse sa mga bahay nila. Parang homeschooling, kumbaga. And Yale University in 1923 was the first nursing education that was established in the United States of the basis of education rather than the needs of hospital. So, dito pala mas inuuna na nila yung pagtuturo sa mga nurse kesa sa pangangailangan ng mga hospital. Then, this really set the stage for the future of education. And since then, universities across the nation have developed nursing program of their own. So yun nga, mas inuna na nila yung pagtuturo, kaya mga parang iba't ibang bansa, nagkakaroon na sila ng kanya-kanyang way pagtuturo sa mga nurse. Such as Columbia University in 1950s, tulad nun. And today, nursing education has traveled the road to development to such an extent that is available at college campuses via online courses. Katulad na sa atin, online class. And even through nursing continuing education, men and women who want to become a nurses can do so around their schedule and take advantage of all study option for this amazing profession. So, dito na tayo sa last. In the United States, lecture and instruction manual were offered for women to learn how to give care to women during childbirth and postpartum period. Dito pala, tinuturuan na silang magpanak ng mga kapwa nila babae, ganun. And civil war caused many more women to join the rising number of hospital offering nurse training that was more an apprenticeship than the training program we see later. Ah, dito mas dumadami na yung mga babae na hikayat na mag-nurse. Yun lang. So, dito naman sa number 4 question. Modern practice of nursing. We all know that nurses play a huge part. They provide a treatment to patients, offer education to the community about maintaining their health. Within the past few generations, nurses have been playing a vital role in the society. Together with the medical professional, they are also recognized as a pillar in the medical field. Kaya lang naman tinawag na pillars in the medical field yung mga nurse. Kasi yung pillars para silang mga support, ganun. So yun, yung mga nurse support sila ng mga medical professional, gaya ng mga doctors, ganun. Technology has changed dramatically in past 10 years, especially with the advent of the smartphones. Siguro, alam naman natin yun, di ba, yung pag-upgrade ng mga cellphone. Thus, as the use of the technology in medical practices increase, nurses are on the forefront of shaping and utilizing new mobile health tools. Technology in nursing has many benefits. Faster communication, efficient charting, increased patient safety, and faster lab results. Siguro, yun nga, pag mas maganda yung technology, mas accurate, ganun, kaya nasasabi ditong increased technology patient. Has also led to the safety. Increase in the telemedicine options. Telemedicine is changing the way patient care provided in a growing number of intensive care units across the country. The last part is modern nurse outlines emerging nursing roles, such as developing simulation technology, flying into emergency situations, or establishing a practice in local. Liberia's part of public health initiative. New specialties has increased leadership opportunities, and the use of telemedicine and mobile health are just a few of the ways that nursing has changed in the past 10 years. Yun lang, sinabi lang dito na mas malaking in-improve ng mga nurse simula dati dahil sa technology.
And for the last part, modern tools or technologies in nursing, old and now. The old tools that the nurses used. Glass syringe. Since the Roman times in the 1st century AD, syringes have been used for medical treatment as described in the world-renowned De Medicina book. But it was only in 1946 when glass syringes were mass-produced for medical use. Iron lung. The external negative pressure ventilator, possibly known as the iron lung, is one of the most popular vintage medical equipment around due to its enormous size and widespread usage in the 1950s. Mercury sphygmomanometer. It was made from a calibrated glass tube filled with mercury. In 1896, Dr. Scipione Rivarocci devised an inflatable cup connected to the sphygmomanometer for easier blood pressure reading. Cigarette. A cigarette was widely used during the World War II era. It resembled a super glue tube but functions as a portable syringe. It had a close flexible tube and the other end had a hollow needle. It usually contained single dose medicines that could be quickly administered during emergency situations. Jet injector. A jet injector is a needleless injecting device that uses pressurized air to penetrate the epidermis with a specific dosage of medicine or vaccine. The device was developed in the 1960s for mass immunization, smallpox vaccine. Mercury thermometer. In 1740, Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit first created a mercury thermometer. Fahrenheit was a physicist, engineer, and professional glass blower. His mercury thermometer was made from glass calibrated with his own temperature scale. The modern tools and technology. Automated IV pumps controls the dosages and drips given to patients. Sphygmomanometer is simply a fancy term for electric blood pressure cuffs that also measures heartbeat rate automatically. Gone are the days when a nurse had to measure blood pressure manually. Portable defibrillator. Manual CPR can only do so much, and for the longest time, this was the only method available to many nurses for reviving someone's heart. Now, even school nurses stand a fighting chance to save the life of a person whose heart has failed. The few minutes after heart failure are critical. The portable defibrillator allows for immediate resuscitative action. The sonogram or ultrasound. Ultrasound devices provide nurses working with pregnant patients the ability to see inside the womb. Ultrasound has been nothing short of revolutionary in the field of women's health and pregnancy, allowing nurses and doctors to non-invasively identify enabled devices, make monitoring hospital assets easier, ranging from drugs and equipment to records and patients. They also enhance safety and security with less effort and lower long-term cost. Smart beds. Smart bed technologies can help nurses track movement, weight, and even vitals. Wearable devices. Wearable devices and mobile apps are transforming the healthcare industry. Devices that help track heart rate, exercise, sleep, respiration, and more are helping people take their health into their own hands. Electronic IV monitors. With the advent of IV pump infusion and electronic monitoring, nurses are freed up to initiate an IV and allow a machine to monitor and regulate the process. If there is an emergency, today, the demand for nursing remains high, and projections suggest that such demand will substantively increase. Advances in healthcare technology, rising expectations of people seeking care, and reorganization of healthcare systems require a greater number of highly educated professionals. Demographic changes, such as large aging populations in many countries of the world, also fuel this demand.